Uh-oh, my email is showing that I've used 74% of my storage space. And with all of my attachments and all of those future incoming emails, the rest of this is going to go rather quickly. So what is the easiest way that I can recover my email storage without having to do some type of filter or search or manually go through my largest emails? In this video, I'm going to show you an easy and free tool so you can declutter and regain that storage in just a few minutes. Recently, Samebox released a new feature called Email Deep Clean, specifically designed for those of us who are running out of storage space or who just want to declutter their inbox. So let me show you how easy it is to use. Now, not only is Samebox's Deep Clean feature free, but it also works with any email client. So whether you use Gmail, Outlook, Microsoft 365, or Apple Mail, you can use this Deep Clean feature. In this example, I'm going to be using my Outlook account. Now, the alternative would be for me to go through one by one, or maybe pick some date in the past and just hope that there's nothing valuable that I'm going to permanently delete. But with the Deep Clean feature, we can do it so much more effortlessly and do it in just a few clicks. Here I am within my Samebox account, and you can see that I've already connected it with my Outlook address listed here. Now, of course, you can make use of all of the other features here within Samebox, including their AI folders, which will automatically separate your important and less important emails. And the more that you use it and train it, the better it gets. But we're going to be focused on the Deep Clean feature. So I'm going to select View Emails here. Now, if it's your first time using this feature within Samebox, all you will see is this date window and the scan button here. But because I've already made use of this with my account, it's showing me the details of my last scan. So for example, earlier today, I scanned for emails that were older than the year 2022. But before I get to the details down below, let's do a new scan. So I'm going to click on this calendar window here, and I'm going to jump up a little bit. I'm going to select January 1st of this year. I'm going to assume that the first 2 months are emails that I'm going to want to keep, but in this case, I want it to go back and scan everything before this date. Now, all I have to do is select rescan, or if it's your first time, it will say scan. Now, depending on how many emails and size of attachments that you have within your email client, this could take a few minutes. Of course, it's going to vary by user, but you don't have to stay on this screen. Samebox will automatically email you an update when this scan is over. So you don't have to waste your time. You can get on with your day and do something else and then come back when the scan is completed. But you'll notice here that it's giving me an update. We're about 1/3 of the way through of this particular scan. So it should probably only take maybe another minute or so to complete. So my scan just completed, and it probably lasted no more than 2 minutes to scan through all of my emails older than this calendar year. What you'll see now is a collection of emails that have been put together in a few different ways that are most helpful when we're trying to decide what we can get rid of for good. First off, you can see that we can group these emails together either by the most storage used or total messages. So just to clarify what that means, if we scroll down here, you can see michaelhyatt.com. This sender is in the number one spot for storage used. And beside it, you can see there's a total of 19.3 megabytes, all attributed to this sender. If we go down the line in descending order, you can see that that size will change. But we can also choose total messages. It may just take a second to resort. In this case, Michael Hyatt is still the most with 244 emails, but Moore's Clothing now comes in second with a total of 42 emails. So this may come down to how much storage space you're wanting to get rid of. That's usually what is calculated when it comes to your email provider. Or if you're just more focused on decluttering, you may be wanting to pay closer attention to the total number of messages. At this stage, what I can do is go through and either select all, if I'm confident I want to get rid of everything, or I can start to sift through these different senders. And I think that's the real power here, is that it automatically groups everything together. Now, if I come down to a particular sender here and I say to myself, do I want to keep that? Do I want to know a little bit more? I can come over here to the right and say, show more. And what that will do is give me some additional information. First, it's going to tell me that it belongs in the inbox. Now, this is based on Sanebox's analysis of my email and my email habits. It's going to tell me the last message that I received from them, and then it's going to show me some recent subjects. So this is really helpful if any of these are going to trigger my memory or if I'm going to decide if I want to keep or get rid of this sender. For any of these, if I select them, I'm going to select this one and maybe this one and one more down below. Now I can go ahead and safely select trash selected. Now, after selecting this button, it's going to give us a warning. Am I absolutely sure I want to move all the messages from these three contacts to my trash folder? It's also going to tell me the total amount of space that I'm saving. There is no undo available for this action. Now, keep in mind, it is only moving these messages to the trash folder at this point. Most of our email clients will automatically get rid of everything in the trash within about 30 days. So if I want to go ahead and manually erase them after this step, I can do so. But what it means is that it's going to move all of these messages from wherever they may be, from the inbox, from a special folder, from a label, from anywhere within my account. In this case, I'm going to say I'm sure, and I'm going to select confirm. And at this stage, it will proceed with moving our selections to the trash. Just like when it did the scan, we don't have to stay on this screen. We can keep an eye on the progress here, but it will send us an automatic email when this step has completed. And once Sanebox has finished moving all of my selected emails to the trash folder, I'll be returned to the email deep clean screen. And I can continue to go through if I want to, as my results will still be shown down below. But of course, I can use this tool as frequently or as often as I like. So if you want to declutter your inbox or regain all of that email storage, go to sanebox.com/simpletivity1 or click the link in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.